All right, I'm gonna narrate a little of this. We got something hooked up here on my Shimano Takotas and my Tsunami rods that literally feels. At first, it's on top, and then the tire starts running. We've all fought it and cannot move it. I'm thinking it's a stingray hooked in the wing, but let me tell you, it's the biggest goddamn stingray I think I've ever hooked. It was a mullet. It was a mullet, a chunk of mullet. So I don't know what this thing is, but we're all trying it. We were trying to catch a big bull red, and then all of a sudden this rod started bouncing in the rod holder. I mean, look at Ricky's on this thing here, man. And I mean, you can't budge this thing. We had to pull the anchor and everything. And all we want to do is see it.
I just want to see it.
That's it. We got some Colorado boys here on the boat, and they didn't know they were showing up to go catch the, you know,
great white shark.
Yeah, I mean, we can't even budge this thing. So. Yeah. All right, here's the story. We can't budge this son of a gun, no matter what. Whatever we got, and he just starts running across the bottom. So, we have to tie this thing to the cleat or something and drive away. Because you can't even break it. Burning up all our redfish time on this thing. I'm gonna try to grab the line. I'll do it with a glove. Unbelievable. I think the tropical storm here brought something into the jetties here. Alright, let's see what we can do here. The 30-pound Hercules braid to the cleat. To the cleat of the boat.
Oh,
there it goes. It popped right at the cleat. Whatever that is has now got 60 or 70 feet of line to its face. Okay, let's go catch a redfish.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be nice? Wouldn't that be nice to go catch a goddamn redfish?
Too bad we can't.
Oh my god, whatever the hell that was uncatchable on this tackle. And I mean, those tsunami rods can handle some shit. Oh my god. Alright. Man, I'll turn the camera on if we catch a normal fish.
Sitting around the house, got nothing to do.